गुड इवनिंग एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम टू दी वेबिनार ऑफ होम्योपैथी 360 इन कोलैबोरेशन विद ब्लाच फ्लावर इंडिया. आई होप एवरीबॉडी हैज सेटल डाउन फॉर दी वेबिनार एंड इज रेडी टू लर्न अबाउट एलएम पोटेंसी फ्रॉम आर ग्रेट स्पीकर ऑफ टुडे. सो आई होप एवरीबॉडी इज क्यूरियस टू लर्न द स्टार्ट. इट इज अबाउट टू स्टार्ट गाइज. डॉक्टर ढांडिया, वी आर अबाउट टू स्टार्ट, प्लीज वेट. आई एम गेटिंग कमेंट्स. गुड इवनिंग एवरीबॉडी. So welcome to the webinar today. I hope everybody is excited, and I Dr. Yashika Arora heartily welcome you all to the webinar of today. But before I begin and introduce about our speaker as well as the Batch Flower India, I just want to acquaint you with the webinar software. Whoever has joined us today for the first time, I just want to update you that you have a chat box on your screen on the right side corner, wherein you can type your questions and send to us whenever you have queries. We will be dealing with the question answers in the end of the session after the speaker has wind up with the presentation. So I hope nobody will have issue. You can post your queries in the chat box at any moment, and we'll discuss in the end. Also, I would like to welcome our backend support system, Dr. Rajesh, who is who will be with us for the technical aspect issue, and we will take care that we face no technical errors. Plus, now I would like to introduce you to the platform of Homeopathy 360 as well as Batch Flower India. As everybody knows that Homeopathy 360 is an online website, updated online portal for the publication of all kinds of course material, latest news, updates, upcoming events, research papers, articles, as well as job vacancies, career opportunities that are available all over the world right now. Also during this lockdown period, we always try ki the each and every single information is available on our website, that is www.homeopathy360.com, and we try to make the information universally accessible through this website. And also I would like to invite all our esteemed homeopaths who are with us right now to contribute your knowledge, your experiences, share with your research papers, your case studies with us, and we'll be happy, we'll be glad to publish them on the website. For this, you can mail me at yashika@homeopathy360.com at any moment, or you can directly upload on the website as well. You have an option to submit your articles on the website also. Plus, now I think I've acquainted you with the website platform also, as well as the platform of Homeopathy 360. I want to introduce you to the Batch Flower India platform that they are organizing. They are working hard and organizing classes and providing education about batch flower therapy to the through their website batchflowerindia.com. and we have the great speaker of today with us, who is again an inspiration for many of the homeopaths as well as many of the students all over the world, Mr. Varendra Sonasaria sir. I welcome sir on behalf of Homeopathy 360 to the platform. He's a batch flower registered practitioner. His appetite for knowledge leads him to read Materia Medica, authored by great masters, and homeopathic philosophy too. He has used LM Potency extensively and has a fantastic experience with them. So in an attempt to share his knowledge about how LM Potency is to be used effectively into practice, we have started this webinar for 2 days, that is today as well as on 5th July 2020, wherein we'll be discussing the topics of importance of 6th edition of Organon, the history of LM Potency, philosophy of LM Potency, principles in the use of LM Potency, mathematical calculation of how LM Potency is prepared, important aphorisms concerned with LM Potency, and how to understand them. So we'll be discussing today some of the part as well as the practical aspect. We'll be discussing on the on the 5th of July. So I welcome sir. He has many of the contributions. He completed his Batch Foundation Teachers Program Level 1 by traveling to Batch Center UK, and has become the licensed teacher of Batch Flower Therapy for India. He has distinction of becoming the first teacher in India to conduct batch center approved level 1 course in Hindi as well as Marathi. He has a zeal for helping people to move towards health, wholeness and empowerment, and has a 2-decade experience in reflexology, and is certified by California Hypnosis Institute to conduct session in hypnosis as well. So I hope everybody is very much curious to listen to him, to learn from him today. And for any queries, you can visit his website regarding Bachelor India, that is bachelorindia.com. So now it's high time that I should hand over the session to our speaker of today, Mr. Virendra sir. So I hand over the session to you. Please begin.
Thank you, Dr. Yashika. I welcome all the doctors who have today joined us for this webinar. Dear friends, Dr. Hahnemann said, when we have to do with an art whose end is saving of human life, any neglect to make ourselves master of it becomes a crime. Now here Dr. Hahnemann has placed a big responsibility on us as homeopath, that not making ourselves master of this art is as good as committing a crime. So we all have come across the term organon. Organon is the soul of homeopathy. Organon is where you get why and what of homeopathy. It is rightly said that it is the edifice of homeopathy. And the best part of organon is that there are several additions in organon. Now, why are there several additions? It is because that Dr. Hahnemann, who himself was a great experimenter and had a keen observation, had found that some of his methods and some of his practicable things that he had invented may not be applicable in his future time. So in the further editions of organon, he removed those things which were out of use. That is the best part of Hahnemann. He himself thought that if there are some things which are not applicable, it should be out of the organon. And that is why we have continuous updates from Hahnemann of the organon, and the total number of organons addition are 6. So doctors, we know when were these editions of organon published. The first edition was published in 1810, the second came in 18, then 1824, 1829, 1833, and the most important, the 6th one, which was the final edition of organon, came in the year 1922, which was published by Dr. Borig in English. That is, the English edition became available to all the users of homeopathy in 1922. Now friends, from 1842 to 1922, that is almost 80 years, the organon was not published. We all know that what happened with the organon, the story behind not publishing of organon. But for those of you who would like to know, here is a small thing. The story of 6th edition of organon. Hahnemann had written to Mr. Schwab, who was the publisher of organon, that I have now, after 18 months of work, finished the 6th edition of my organon, the most nearly perfected of all. Now friends, these are very important things. You see that he has worked very hard in the last years of his life, and a man of Hahnemann's stature writes that after 18 months of work, I have finished the 6th edition, which is nearly perfected of all, which means that the earlier editions may have some flaw, which he has corrected in the 6th edition. So it is expected that all of us follow the 6th edition and prescribe and follow the methods given there. But unfortunately, the sixth edition could not be published when Hahnemann himself was alive. Because in 1842, when he wrote to his friend, and in the very next year, on 2nd July 1843, we know Dr. Hahnemann passed away. And sixth edition of Orgonon could not be published because of his publisher's bungling. And also, there are many who have written in their books and also say that the manuscripts remained in possession of Madame Melanie, and who could not, the edition could not see the day of light because of enormous greed for money. It was to the credit of Dr. Hale and William Bory that the sixth edition got published. Friends, if this sixth edition would not have been published, then the novel aspects, the peculiarities, the specialities would have ever remained in dark and beyond the knowledge of mankind. You can imagine that a person, a doctor of Hahnemann's stature, has worked so hard, and when he has given the sixth edition, because of all these things, it could not be published. So for those 80 years, all over the world, wherever homeopathy traveled, wherever homeopathy was practiced, it was based on fifth edition. When this word has been written, that due to Madame Melanie, because of her greed, the sixth edition could not be published, I thought it advisable that let us know some other aspects of Madame Melanie. So I am quoting from one book. It is from the later years of Hahnemann. In this book, on page number 12, it is written, after Hahnemann's death, her priority was to continue the Paris practice which they had established together, and she did this effectively for some time. Now here it is written that the Paris practice was established by Dr. Hahnemann and Mrs. Hahnemann together. We all know that Hahnemann's marriage was a love marriage, and they worked very hard to establish homeopathy in the Paris. I am not going into the details of how Hahnemann moved from places and came to Paris to practice homeopathy. But if you read the further lines, it is said her professional life was extremely busy, and she appears never to have either the time or the resources to settle down to publishing Hahnemann's material accurately, though she made several attempts both to supervise others and to find the time and space to do it herself. So this aspect of Madame Melanie also has to be taken into account, and we should not portray her just that she was very greedy and she would not publish the sixth edition. Whatever the cause may be, but the truth is that for 80 years, this edition was not published. This is the book from which I am quoting. If any one of you wants to read, it's a very good book. It is writing about the later, in search of the later Hahnemann. It is by Rima Handley. And if you see this writing, which is shown below, these are Hahnemann's original writing and his case papers, which are present in these books. So our topic being the LM potency, what aphorisms in Orgonon are applicable for us, which are more important to us? Of course, we know the entire Orgonon is important for any homeopath, but when we are dealing with LM potency, there are few aphorisms which are very important to us. And the aphorism from 246 to 248 and 253 are especially applicable. Aphorism 280 says, a dose of medicine that continues serviceable without producing new troublesome symptom is to be continued while gradually ascending, so long as the patient with general improvement begins to feel in mild degree the return of one or several old complaints. This indicates an approaching cure through a gradual ascending of moderate doses modified each time by succession. So if there they have quoted that, read aphorism 247. So friends, just see, those who are believing or those who are trying to venture into jumping potencies of LM, in this aphorism, it is written down by the master himself, gradually ascending. So he is not mentioning anywhere jumping potencies. There, I know some people who start with LM3, they may go to LM5, 7, or whatever they begin. But for all the beginners in LM potency, the master has laid down, go from the lowest sixth scale and gradually ascend till the patient feels the general improvement. Now, this is a very important thing in LM potency. When you start with LM potency, at the very first, at the very beginning, the patient will experience some kind of what we say amelioration. And as you go with the treatment further, then he says it begins to feel in mild degree the return of one or several old original complaints. So there are two parts of it, either one, several old and original complaints. If it's not original, then something new has come, we have to work our case. But if some one or several old symptoms have come, it means that that client or that patient does not require further doses of that LM medicine. So there you can start stopping gradually. What would have happened in C scale? Even if your medicine would have been correct, even if you had given a similimum, the very first dose could have brought severe aggravation. So there is very less chance to know that the aggravation is due to the right similimum or because of some other factors. And then the doctor has to manage that case very carefully. But with LM potency, this can be totally avoided. Now, one thing is there is footnote 132. I am going to read a few parts of footnote 132. This entire lecture is based only on comments of Dr. Hahnemann and two more sources, which I'll be quoting at the end of this lecture. We are not dealing with anything else which is available on LM potencies in the market. So we have confined these lectures only to what Dr. Hahnemann has said. And I thought it very important that footnote 132 must be read when we are dealing with this. So what does the footnote 132 says? Footnote 132 says, what I have said in the fifth edition of Organon in a long note to this paragraph, in order to prevent these undesirable reactions of vital energy, was all that the experience I then had justified. So see, he says that there were aggravations when he was in the fifth edition, he was practicing with C scale and he had justified them. But during the last 4 or 5 years, however, all these difficulties are wholly solved by new altered but perfected method. Again, the word perfected method is given. The same carefully selected medicine, that is in C scale, may now be given daily for months if necessary in this way, namely after the lower degree of potencies have been used for 1 or 2 weeks in the treatment of chronic diseases, advances is made in the same way to higher degree. So again, as I told you, that ascending scale has to be followed. Beginning according to the new dynamization method taught here with the use of lowest degree. So I think this question comes in many seminars of LM potency, that should we go jumping scale? Should we follow one alternate potencies? So all these things in Organon will put to rest these queries. Now, it goes to the credit of Dr. Charles Pahor and Dr. P.S. Smith, as I mentioned earlier, that they brought out the importance of LM potencies. Dr. Charles, in his article in British Homeopathic Journal during 1950, and Dr. P.S. Smith, in his valuable essays in Journal of American Institute of Homeopathy, what their experiences and their way of treating cases with LM potencies. After that, the whole world was drawn to LM potencies. So we are very indebted. We are grateful to these two doctors for introducing to the world the LM potencies. So dear friends, what was the need for LM potency? The need for LM potency was because aphorism 2 of the Argonaut could not be satisfied. And we all know that with the C scale, there is undesirable medicinal aggravation even after the well-selected medicine is administered. Again, a high dose of medicine continues to act for a long time, and we are forbidden, we are told not to repeat so long as the dose of correct simulum is acting. So we just have to wait, even if the client or your patient is having some kind of discomfort. Repetition of doses is not possible even if there are a remnant of symptom of disease. In consequences, the patient suffers for long time. So all these things were there with C potency till 5th edition. But in the 6th edition, Hahnemann had, as he said that I have bought the perfected method, he eliminated all these things. Now, one more important thing comes in aphorism 246 and 248. Dear friends, before some of you may think that I am taking too much theoretical, I am taking only those parts of theory and principle which are extremely important for you to base your practice, to make your practice in LM potencies very successful. If you know these things, and of course, if you read more, then your practice is definitely going to be very successful in your LM potencies. We are going to come in the next part of lecture with actual preparation and dispensing of LM potencies. But these aphorisms, since they are very important, I am taking it in this webinar. Aphorism 246 states, every perceptible, progressive, and strikingly increasing amelioration during treatment is a condition which, as long as it exists, completely precludes every repetition of administration of any medicine whatsoever, because all the good the medicine taken continues to effect is now hastening towards its completion. So here repetition is not permissible, he has written. So I'm not reading the whole aphorism. The most important lines again are coming in the last part of it. It says, firstly, if the medicine selected with utmost care was perfectly homeopathic, secondly, if it is highly potentized, dissolved in water and given in proper small doses, that experience has taught us the most suitable in definite intervals for the quickest accomplishment of the cure, but with the precaution that the degree of every dose deviate somewhat from the preceding and following, in order that the vital principle which is to be altered to a similar medicine disease be not aroused to untoward reactions and revolt. Again, whatever these things which I mentioned, what was the need, what was the trouble with LM potency, these things have been eliminated. So I think with that, the theoretical part where you find what was the importance of LM potency, what made Hahnemann to work so hard with this potency comes to your highlight. And of course, if you read the Argonaut, you will definitely find few more important things there. So now we come to the practical aspects of LM potencies. Now, when you say how the LM potencies are prepared, you must first remember that the first three potencies of centesimal scale are taken in preparation of LM potencies. So your ratio is 1:100. We all know one part of the original substance is taken and 99 drops of alcohol, they are added, and then we get the 1C. So 1C, 2C, 3C. Up to that scale, we are taking the C scale. Now, from the third scale, there is a change. And what happens in the change is, in the fourth part, in the fourth stratum, what happens is, instead of 100 drops, we are now taking 500 drops, in which 100 drops are of distilled water. 400 drops are of distilled water and 100 drops are of alcohol. This is the fourth stratum, the mother potency, it is called, of the new method. So the ratio has now become 1:500. Instead of 1:100 in C, it is now 1:500. So what happened in the fourth stratum is, up to C, when you had 100 and you added 500 drops, then the combination, then the product gives you 50. So to understand it in a much better way, suppose you got 100 patient in a day and all your patients have paid you 500 rupees. So at the end, you have 3000. So that is how. So from third scale to the fourth scale, when you have moved from 100 to 500. So you must always remember that the base of LM potency is 1:50,000 instead of 1:100 in the C. Now, friends, how are you going to administer the LM potencies? So it is written that take 4 ounces of bottle and clean it properly. 100 ml is available in the market. So, you know, 1 ounce is approximately 30 ml. So 4 ounce will be 120 ml. But I have found that in Mumbai and surrounding area, 120 ml is not available. 100 ml is easily available. So those who want to practice with this, they can take 100 ml. Otherwise, you also get 200 ml. Fill this 3/4 part with water. And add to this 15 to 20 drops of alcohol for preservation. Now, in the globule of LM potencies are very small poppy seeds. So you have to just put one number 10 globule of LM potency remedy of 0/1. Now, this 0/1 is an indication that the LM potency is used for of power 1, just as we have C, 30C, 200C, here it is indicated by 0/1, or some people even write LM/1. So 0/1 indicates LM potency of power 1, 0/2 of second power, like that we have from 1 to 30 potencies. Now this solution is ready for use. Now friends, if you practice with LM potencies and if you get a client who is extremely sensitive to homeopathic treatment, then possibly you will have to dilute this further medicine in the second and third glass of water. So how do we prepare the LM potency? All that is given in footnote 248. So I have, I'm presenting to you these three bottles. The first corner bottle is 100 ml bottle, which is easily available in market. So you can make use of this. 3/4 you can fill with water and then you can add some 15 to 20 drops of alcohol. Add one poppy seed to this. So you have to leave some space above so that you can succus this. This is how your potency will raise. So you need to leave some space up. So if you need to make a larger bottle, this is 200 ml bottle. So this is, you can make this bottle. Once you are comfortable with this, you also know how to use the larger bottles. Now this is the 30 ml bottle or 1 ounce bottle. This bottle is used four times. You have to take water in a glass of water when you are going to dilute with this mother solution. All this aspect, you need not worry, because this practical aspect we are going to take in depth in the second session. Here, I am just introducing you in preparation of LM. Actually, preparation and how you will be dispensing, that we will deal in length with in the second lecture. Now, once you have prepared, suppose I have selected this 100 ml bottle and I have filled 3/4 with water, and remaining I have added 15 to 20 drops of alcohol. Now I have added one poppy globule of the medicine that I have selected in this. What do I do the next? Then succuss this solution for 8 to 10 times. Our experience is that 5 times also is sufficient, but the book says 8 to 10 times. Succussion is essential prior to administering the medicine. Now, this is very important. Some people I know that they are not succussing, and they say that without succussion also they may give the medicine. But footnote to aphorism 282 clearly mentions that succussion is important. And also, when I was reading the Organon for sometimes back, you know that Hahnemann has said that there has to be slight change in the potency. So it will not occur if you are not going to succuss. So succussion is very important. Now take a glass and put 4 ounces of water in it. So you have taken an empty glass and you have to put 4 ounces of water. So this bottle, which is the small bottle of 1 ounce, this you have to count 4 times and put in a glass of water. And put water in this and put in the empty glass 4 times. So it will become 4 times. Now, 4 ounces of water in it. Now, from this medicinal solution, put 1 teaspoon in a glass of water, the glass of water which you have made. It is very important that you put teaspoon. I have seen people putting tablespoon. Tablespoon is a large dose, which is not required. Hahnemann has mentioned clearly that the dose should be minimum, it should be small. So 1 teaspoon is sufficient. Stir it 20 times. This I have inserted because many times people come and question, after I have put from the medicinal solution 1 teaspoon in the glass of water, how many times I must stir? So if you get this question, you give a number, because some people know that after stirring it for a particular time, they have done what the doctor has said. So you can give 10 times also, I don't mind. But any number has to be given if your client behaves that way. Otherwise, it is fine that they have put it and just they have stirred 2-3 times also, it's fine. Now, patient has to take only 1 teaspoon as a dose. This is very important. From that whole glass of water that you have made, medicinal solution now, in the glass of water, the patient has to take just 1 teaspoon. We have come across experience of many people that where patient thinks that 1 teaspoon is not sufficient and they will drink directly from the glass. Now that is harmful. This is not good. You have to educate them that just 1 teaspoon is going to work, because people feel, what will happen in my chronic disease with just 1 teaspoon? Let me take 2. Or if they are benefited, they may possibly try to increase their dose on their own. So educate them and then throw away the rest of the solution. Now we come to the very important part about the dosages. How are you going to give the medicine? In very urgent cases, you can give it every hour or still oftener. So even 15 and 20 minutes sometimes is necessary. For if your case is in an emergency or if it's a very urgent case. If it is an acute disease, then you can repeat it every 2 to 6 hours. Now you know that if it had been C, we would have to wait. But in LM potency, we have this possibility that we can repeat it. So repeat it every 2 to 6 hours if required. Daily or every second day in chronic disease. Now this is very important. We have got the option now that anyone who is with chronic diseases can be given the doses repeatedly, that is every day or every second day, which was not in C potency. Suppose if the patient cannot tolerate these doses and if aggravation appears at the end of the treatment, then the doses are to be applied at longer intervals. Now, this is also given in aphorism 200 and 280 and 281. So what it says is, when aggravation is appearing at the end of the treatment, then you know that either you are going to stop that medicine or you are going to prolong the interval. There is an exception, which is to the smallest dose of medicine or the minimal dose that we call. And if you want to read, I'm not taking here because then the lecture time would be required, would be too long. So it is given in aphorism 282. Anyone, if they are interested, what is the exception to the smallest dose? Now, some of you, I took this again from the same book by Rima Hadley. It says that Mr. M. Ruzolt in 1840 was the first person who got LM potency from Dr. Henneman. See, it is mentioned here, thus becoming the first person to receive the new LM potency. Just so that we know that such things are all very well documented. And from that time onwards, LM potency was beginning to use. Although, as I mentioned, that in middle 80 years, we did not have the addition of sixth addition of organon. And then we had to stop. Again, it started thanks to the doctors who have taken effort in procuring those original organon additions. Now, for my this lecture, I have taken these three main books as my reference tool. One is the most important one is Organon by sixth edition by Dr. Henneman. We all know. Then In Search of Later Henneman by Rima Hadley. This book also I have taken, as I've shown you some things from this book. And I have taken from Dr. Chowdhury's book, 50 millisievert potency. Now, if you want to go in depth about how the 50 millisievert potency, mathematical calculations, those are all given in this book. You can read this book and you will get in depth. Also in the Organon, when you read the particular aphorisms, you will come to know what are and how the LM potencies are prepared and how the doses are given. So that brings us to the end of this lecture. And as I told you that this webinar was basically to give an introduction and also to update you. Suppose tomorrow if you get a client whom you are going to use LM potency, then I have explained to you how much the solution should be, how you are going to prepare, what should be the succession, and what should be the dose that you are going to give to your patient. And when you are going to increase, when you are going to stop, all that thing we have done in part one. In part two, we are going to go in little in depth and we will be dealing only with the practical aspects of LM potencies. I here take this opportunity to thank Team 360, who had been very cordial and helpful for organizing my webinar here. And I am also thankful that my colleague, Dr. Falguni Gaitonde, who has been instrumental in making this webinar a great success, and also to all the participants who have taken out their valuable time and have listened to my webinar with such apt attention. I'm thankful to all of you and also to God and Dr. Henneman. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. I think we can have a question answer session now for the doubts. We can clear the doubts and queries we have from the speaker, from the audience. I request the audience to please post your queries in the chat box, whatever doubts and queries you have. Sir, there was a question from Dr. Pankaj. He's having confusion about the drug strength of 0/1 and 0/2.
Okay, what was the question?
Sir, he is confused about the drug strength 0 by 1, 0 by 2, and also its comparison with mother tincture, I think he wants to know.
Okay, see, now if that is your doubt, then how potency 0 by 1 is increased to potency 0 by 2? That is a very mathematical calculation. I have that. And if someone has come with that query, let me show you. So that all of you can understand. Yeah, so Dr. Pankaj, this was your question, how, what is the strength in LM1 and 2? See, in if you study aphorism 270 and 271, it says that take original substance, one drop, 1 grain, plus 100 grains of sugar of milk. For 1 hour, you have to titrate. This is your first titration. So its strength is 1/100. Similarly, when you do it for the second time, that is second titration, it will be 1/100 multiplied by 1/100. So it will give you the strength of 1/10,000. Now you are going to do it for the third time. So you will take it 1/10,000, this from here, and 1/100 again, same process. So you get a strength of 1/10,000 now. And as I told you, while preparing LM potency, from the third C, you are going to take 500 drops. So if you take 500 drops here, you are going to put the original substance, that is 1/10,000, into 1/500. So that will give you the power of mother potency. So this is the number that we actually are going to get. That is 1 part of original substance into this much part of your dilution. Now, so this is the way LM potencies are prepared. Now you can go this way to LM2. So this number which has come in LM1, 1 drop from here, again upon 1:500 over here. So that way, if you go, then you get LM2. Any other question, Dr. Yashiga?
I saw many questions. Which type of cases are more suitable for the use of LM potencies?
I could hear you properly. What was your question?
Which type of cases are more suitable for LM potencies, for use of LM potencies?
Yeah, let me tell you, you can use in all cases. You can use it in cases with mental disturbances. You can, because see, where suppose if you're going to give some C potencies, where you have to give one dose and ideally what is written in organ and you have to wait. But here you can give repeated doses in all chronic skin and other complaints, then in diseases where organs are involved. So there is no such thing that your LM potency is less beneficial than your C potency. You can use it everywhere. In fact, you can be assured that in the beginning there will be amelioration, and one guiding symptom is that at the end of the treatment you will get slight aggravation where you can stop your medicine or you can, as I told, prolong the doses. Yes, Dr. Yashika, next.
Thank you, sir. There is one more question from Dr. Falguni only. From Dr. Meeta, there is a question. In which cases we can start directly with LM potency instead of centesimal scale?
No. Again, as this question is, I think I've answered that. There is no thing that you have to go C in some case and come to LM. Suppose you have given C scale and you feel that you have to start with LM, you can as well come to LM and start your medicine. You can give your simulimum. But don't jump into C and LM. Once you have given LM of the same medicine and you feel something is wrong with LM, let me try with C. Those things should not be done. It should be avoided. You can use both the potency in anything, either C or LM. They are equally beneficial.
Thank you, sir. There is one more question. Do we get better results with the use of vellum potencies?
Yeah, we get. I have seen that. It's a good thing.
There is a question from Dr. Pratiksha Patil. She's asking, here the original substance means centesimal, that is 1C. The original substance while preparation of
That is what up to 3C original substance comes from the C potencies, and then 1 is to 500 drops you are going to take. So only that dilution will change. So it will give you the base of 1 upon 50,000.
Thank you, sir. There is one more question from Dr. Anil Yadav. When you give level potency every hourly, then you have to discard the previous medicine after taking one spoon.
Yes. Yeah, this is a good question. Every time when you are giving the same potency, then you can discard it, raise the potency, give a succession and make a fresh dose and give. Otherwise, also some people do it that in the glass of water, they will add some same amount of water again. So that also will have an effect. It will be little more diluted. So potency will not remain the same. So you can use both the ways. Either you can increase by succession or you can add water, plusing method.
Thank you, sir. There's one more question from Dr. Lopa. Can CLM and centesimal potency be used together?
I told that I answered that question. They can be used, but not at the same time. You either use C or you use LM. Your drug can be, suppose you have selected X drug and you are giving in C, but you feel that somehow you have to now give repeated doses, which you are unable to give in C, you can shift to LM, but don't give LM and C together, morning LM, evenings C, or this way. That thing is not good. You know, stick to one thing then.
Sir, can you please post your email ID in the chat box? People are requesting for the email and contact.
Yeah, we have given it. So I
didn't give it yet.
I'll post it.
Yeah, if you allow me, I will post it, sir.
Yeah, we will post it.
Yeah. So there are more questions, sir. When you use it in repeated doses, do you have to use it from the same glass of four O's?
Yeah, 4 rounds. That is what she's writing. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yeah. So do you use it from the same 4 rounds or you prepare more?
As I told you, preparation of LM potency is you take 4 ounces of water in an empty glass of water, and then you add from mother solution 1 teaspoon to that, stir it and give it to your client, your patient. Now, if as I have answered this earlier also, suppose you have to give repeated doses every hourly. So what will you do? Either you add by plusing method some water to the glass of water glass itself, or you can again start succussing and increasing potency very little and make fresh glasses and give it. So that is the way you will be dealing with it. I hope I've answered that. If she needs any clarification, she can write to me on the mail. I'll answer that.
I will just post your email ID for the audience. I've posted sir's mail ID in the chat box. There are more questions, sir. Is LM low, medium or high potency?
No, LM potency doesn't, there is no this thing. Like, yeah, we know in C that 10M, 50M, CM will be high potencies. So here we have not graded. We all go in the ascending scale. They are good potencies.
Thank you, sir. There is one more question.
Dr. Yashika, what was the email you have posted?
Sir, I have posted the email of virensonasaria@gmail.com.
Okay.
Is it fine?
Yeah, or
yeah,
you
can
use the You have
Sorry?
That? Okay, fine. You send it to me.
No, I don't have it.
Okay,
You can just spell. Spell. I will type it. Don't worry. You can just spell.
BACH.
Yes, sir.
Flower India.
Okay.
@gmail.com.
Great. I have posted that email ID as well. You will be getting the recording on YouTube, on our YouTube channel of Homeopathy 360, Dr. Dips. Sir, people are requesting if you can share the VPD. You can have the recording on available on YouTube soon. We'll make it available. Sir, there is a last question from Dr. Deepthi. Can LM potency be used in case of emergency? If a proper constitutional remedy is given, how frequently we can repeat it?
See, LM potencies can be used in emergencies as well as chronic. It gives very good results at both the places. And as I have mentioned, every doctor will have to take his own call. If a patient is in a very emergency state and he has to repeat his medicine every hourly, he can do that. Here, the best part is, all doctors, please note that LM is very economical also. It is going to cost very less, but at the same time, it is very powerful also. And it is gentle. Although it is powerful, it is gentle. It is not going to create very aggravations that we usually get to see in the C potencies. Next, Dr. Yashika.
Thank you, sir. Please compare the merits and demerits of LM and centesimal.
We have that in our second lecture, as I told. Today's lecture was just an introduction. I would have loved to talk to you more, but because we have to finish this in 1 hour, and I love to take your questions, so I have kept more time for you people. And in the second part, we will deal with that comparison also. Meanwhile, if you have some specific queries, if you post that on the mail, I will try to answer them if it is a general inquiry of many of you.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Rinkle, please type your question again. I think I missed it. I missed the question. Please type it again. I'm sorry, Dr. Rinkle. There is one more question, sir. Many legendary doctors use first C potency, then LM potency. Can you say comment on this thing?
I am not a legendary and I don't want to comment on that. What Organon has written, and you follow that. You'll get that thing in Organon. Please read, doctor.
Sure, sir. Dr. Rinkle, please type in your question. I missed your question. Please type it again. What is plussing method people want to ask? Dr. Nazima wants to ask.
Okay, see, what I'll do is plussing method, again, that topic is in the second lecture. So I see that some of the participants have left. Again, they will have this thing we did not know. So what we'll do, whatever is there in the second, we will keep it there. I am going to take that plussing method in the second lecture.
Sir. In for nosodes, which potency we should use, sir?
Sorry, I couldn't hear. Which nosode? What you said?
Which potency we should use in nosodes?
See, as far as I know, the LM potencies are not available for all the medicine, and especially for nosodes, they have not come here, at least in parts of Mumbai. So, and anywhere if you wish to start with LM, please start with the lowest potency, that is 0/1. And then you can go for ascending scale.
Thank you, sir. What are the cups? She is asking. Dr. Rinkle has put the question. You said if aggravation occurs, we can prolong the time for the next dose. But yeah, LM is a very small potency, so how can the patient get aggravation?
Yeah, when you will practice it thoroughly, you will come to know. Aggravation is not like C, but yeah, they will come and say that the doctor, my original thing, you know, that left-sided headache, abhi thoda thoda fir se aaya, that has come back little, not very severe. So you know that he has come to me for this complaint and slowly it has come. We usually, whoever doctor has asked this, I deal in when we teach LM in depth. So there is some webinar where we go in depth. So you come to know that when you are giving repeated doses of LM, how would you compare that the original thing is coming back? How will you taper off your doses? Then there is ascending scale and descending scale also. So all that is taken in those courses, because here, if you don't know the basic and if I take all this, it will be too much for you. But yes, this thing is there. Original symptom will come back at the end of the treatment, very slightly, not with severe aggravations.
Thank you, sir. What are cups? Many doctors from Kolkata use this method. Can you throw some light?
See, which cups are you saying? The dilutions. If I, what you are asking and what I understand is, what I have mentioned, that in some cases, from one glass of water, so instead of cup, they will put in another cup, again one more cup. So some people take it 5 cups. So it is that much dilution and give it to your client. Now, the earlier doctor who had asked this question, that LM potencies are so mild, how can they give aggravation? So just, doctor, remember that there are some practitioners who are putting the LM potency in the 5th cup or 5th glass, and from that they are taking, giving the medicine to that patient, and still they are getting good results. So you understand that when you have seen those mathematical calculation, when you go to LM2, LM3, mathematically you have gone so far ahead, your potentization of medicine has increased so much, your energy has increased so much, that sometimes it will become incomprehensible. So don't go that the original substance has gone. You remember that you have increased the energy. So the power in the medicine has increased. That is what Hahnemann wanted us to take from LM. Next.
There is one question. Can we directly start from LM potency instead of centesimal potency?
Yes, you can start.
Can we directly start?
Yes, you can start. No need to go C and LM, as I told. You can start with LM also.
Dr. Pavan wants to ask. Dr. Jamitika says that it is important that a slight aggravation is necessary. Dr. Pavan is commenting. Hello.
Yeah, I'm listening. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah, hello.
Yes, Dr. Pavan is commenting that it is important that a slight aggravation is necessary. It is also an indication of if the remedy is right, that the remedy is right. He's just commenting.
So you want me to answer that, or yeah, is it is his question or comment? So it's for everybody.
It's just a comment for everybody to share.
That's a good thing.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, so Dr. Pawan, for your comment.
There one more question. According to 0/1 potency, can we give 30 dispense as it is in LM scale?
See, I could not get your voice. What was it? Can you repeat, please?
I couldn't even understand the question. Sir, I couldn't even understand the question.
Please ask them to post it.
0/1 potency.
Send the email. I'll answer that. Please send the email.
Yeah. So, Dr. Pankaj, I request you to please mail, sir, and he'll answer your queries. Please post if you have any questions. Dr. Deepa wants to know if we give LM potency medicine directly without water.
Yeah, there is.
Can we give very little?
Yeah, Dr. Deepa, see, when I was reading the Organon, Dr. Hahnemann has specifically mentioned that if you give the new method in water, so that is more important. There are some doctors who are practicing giving LM in dry also. So it's their choice. But since I told you in the beginning of lecture that we will base everything on the Organon, Organon has mentioned that put one globule in so much water. So we will use that.
So there is a request from Dr. Divya. Can we please have sessions on batch flower remedies?
Yeah, why not? I'll be happy.
Falguni wants to know if simillimum selected is wrong, what is the criteria?
That is not the topic of this webinar. I would answer that, Dr. Falguni. I'll you put me a mail, I'll answer that, because if you select a wrong simillimum, how can anyone expect good results from any scale, of be it LM, be it C? If simillimum is wrong, you will not get results.
Dr. Divya is asking to do plan the Dutch flower remedies discussion soon. She wants to request you. So we'll be planning, don't worry, we'll be planning a session on Dutch flower as well. So thank you so much, sir. I think we come to the end of this webinar as well. We have answered all the queries of the audience as well. So I am very thankful to you, sir, on behalf of the whole team of Homeopathy 360, Manish sir and Vijay Publishers, that you spared out time to take such a nice session on LM potency. That was a very required topic and a very important topic which people wants to learn about. So thank you so much, sir, for your time as well as your efforts and such a nice presentation. I seriously enjoyed it too much. So thank you. And also I want to update all the audience that we'll be coming up with the next session of LM Potency Only with Sir Viren sir on 5th of July 2020. You will be mailed the link of that the registration. You can visit www.homeopathy360.com for the webinar details and the registration link, or you can mail me at webinar@homeopathy360.com. I'll revert back you the link to register. And thank you so much. We'll be planning the session, and as well as we'll put the recording of this session on our YouTube channel soon, by night or tomorrow. So I hope everybody's doubts are cleared, sir. There is one question, I think last question, which we can discuss in 2 minutes. What is the difference between the potencies of homeopathy and batch flower remedy?
See, this was not the topic, but let me tell you, but this question has come. In homeopathy, we increase the potency by succussion, but Dr. Batch had avoided all that altogether. So there is no potency as such in batch flower. Batch flowers are, we can say, all mother tinctures.
Thank you so much, sir. So thank you audience for patient listening. For future webinars, you can visit our website or www.homeopathy360.com. We have an upcoming webinar tomorrow as well of Dr. B.S. Bhosle, sir. So if you want, you can visit the website and register for the same. So thank you so much, sir, on behalf of my whole team. And I hope we come to the end of the session of today, but there is never an end. Learning never ends till the end of the life. So we'll be coming tomorrow. We'll be coming on 5th of July again with sir, and we'll be learning about LM potency first. Then Dr. Pawan, we'll be surely learning about batch flower remedies. So don't worry, we'll be connecting. with him, and you can have a look on your chat box. I have posted the mail ID of sir. You can connect to him through his mail ID.
So Dr. thank Yashika, you so much. If they are interested in bank cover, you can give the site address where I have given sufficient information for anyone. It is www.batch.
Yeah, I will just post batchcar.india.
So, yeah, you have
batchcar.india.com.
Yeah, so they can go there, visit there.
You can visit batchcarindia.com also for any updates you want. So, sir, we come to the end of the session.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much for the session. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. So, thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you.